Alright, we are going to start again from occipital lobe, just as we've been doing. This is a series of videos from Greatness Club International on neurology. And we are talking about today, we're talking about all the time about the cortical symptoms and syndromes of cortical affection, things that will happen when the cortex is being affected. And we talked about, we grouped them under the different lobes. And we talked about the positive, negative symptoms, symmetric and asymmetric negative symptoms. And right now we're going to be talking about the occipital lobe. Occipital lobe, believe me, is a very, very interesting lobe. Love this lobe so much. Without this lobe, we can't be seeing ourselves, right? Because there are things that we are going to be talking about, known as cortical blindness, that if the occipital lobe is affected, even if your eyes are shining like a torchlight, shining like a dog or lion, you cannot see anything because there will be bilateral affection of the occipital lobe and there will be blindness. Alright, quickly, as we've been doing, first of all, we are going to learn some basic functions of the occipital lobe, and I want you to also flow with us and watch the video to the end. God bless you. Alright, one of the basic functions of the occipital lobe that we know is, of course, what? Occipital lobe is the lobe of what? Vision. So it's very, very important to know that. Okay, and when we talk about the occipital lobe being the lobe for vision, it's not just the whole of the lobe. Yeah, I know there are radiating fibers that go to everywhere, but there are very two important gyrus that we need to talk about. Gyrus or cuneatus, and gyrus lingualis. This gyrus cuneatus takes what? Visual information from the upper part of the what? The retina, upper part of the retina. And this one lingualis takes from the lower part of the retina, lower part of the what? Retina, cuneatus, and what? Lingualis. And it's also important for us to know that the information that gets to the occipital lobe goes more to the medial side of the occipital lobe. These are scientifically proven. Alright, so since we are growing in medicine, it's good for us to know some specifics and not just what the general idea of occipital lobe is vision. No. Know that it goes to basically two important gyrus, cuneatus and lingualis. Cuneatus takes information from the upper part of the retina, the lingualis from the lower part of the retina. More of the medial side of the gyrus is where this information goes to. Alright, now let's quickly go to the positive signs of what? Positive signs of occipital lobe affection. So positive signs of occipital lobe affection. Positive signs of occipital lobe affection. Now, one of the basic positive signs of occipital lobe affection, of course, nobody should even waste much time on this, is called what? Visual hallucination. Visual what? Hallucination. Visual hallucination. Visual hallucinations. Now, visual hallucinations will be observed in this patient. Now, patient will replace reality with what? Hallucinations. Will replace reality with what? Hallucination. Typical hallucination is always black and white, but some patients with some diseases, you're going to see some colored hallucinations. Alright, the next type of positive symptoms of occipital lobe affection, of course, is going to be what? Photopsia. Photopsia. What is photopsia? Photopsia, this is short primitive what? Visual hallucinations which are due to what? Short irritation of occipital lobe. Short primitive visual hallucinations which are due to short irritation of what? Occipital lobe. So that's photopsia. These are some of the basic primary what positive symptoms of occipital lobe affection. Basic primary positive symptoms. Occipital lobe affection, they are visual hallucinations and what? Photopsia. Visual hallucination and photopsia. Let's go to what? The negative symptoms. The negative what? Symptoms. Negative symptoms. First of all, we always start from symmetric symptoms, right? Symmetric symptoms. One of the most important symmetric symptoms of what? Occipital lobe affection, negative symmetric symptoms, of course, it's what we call a visual anosmia. Visual what? Anosmia. Visual anoxia. Visual what? Anoxia. Anoxia. When patient is unable to identify him or herself or object. Patient is unable to identify an object or him or herself. So sometimes patient walk to the mirror and look at the mirror and this is not me. No, this is not me. You know, patient does not understand. understand that this is him or her. Patient will look at the object and could not identify the object. It's called what? Visual what? Anosmia. The next type of what symptom the patient will observe is what we call metamorphopsia. Wrong perception of different shapes of objects. Patient will perceive, his perception of shapes of objects is wrong. It's different. It's in a different dimension. Patient can tell you, wow, this pen or this writer is very long, very huge. You know, it's shaped like a ball. It's shaped like, you know, shaped like different kind of things. It can tell it's cylindrical or it's this. So patient will have different wrong perception of what shapes of what different object. And remember, metamorphopsia is always prime in ophthalmology when you use the Amsler's grid to check the patient. With the Amsler's grid, the patient is able to check the different shapes of objects. Right? Alright. Now that's visual anosmia, metamorphopsia. The next thing that the patient is going to observe is what we call the word cortical blindness. Cortical blindness occurs when there is a bilateral affection of the word occipital lobe. When there is bilateral affection of the occipital lobe, patient loses what? Vision. Patient is unable to see even if the eyes are shining as bright as torchlights. Right? So cortical what? Blindness. The next type of what? Negative symmetric symptoms of what? Occipital lobe affection. Of course, it's what? Achromatognosia. Patient is unable to differentiate colors. It's called cortical diatonism or diatonism. Achromatognosia. Diatonism is seen in a lot of cases, right? So, achromatognosia. Or the color pens is really fading right now. Alright, so achromatognosia. Patient is unable to identify different types of what? Colors. Patient is unable to differentiate different types of what? Colors, achromatognosia. Then the next thing is what? Chrodantopia. What's chrodantopia? Bilateral what? Blindness in different quadrants or quarters of the what? Eye. Bilateral blindness in different quarters of the eye. These are some of the basic what? Symmetric what? Negative symptoms of occipital lobe affection. Visual anosmia, visual cortical blindness, achromatognosia, cortical diatonism, that which is achromatognosia, and of course, quadrantopia. All right, now let's quickly go to the word negative asymmetric word symptoms of occipital lobe affection. It's very, very important. If you have visual anosmia, if you are unable to identify objects, if you can't identify objects, can't identify yourself, how can you read? How can you calculate? So patient will have a symptom called what? Alexia and acalculia. Alexia and acalculia. Patient is unable to calculate and patient is unable to what? Read. Alexia and what? Acalculia. Patient is going to have some affections of the temporal lobe and that and that. But it's very of very prime importance is acalculia and what? Alexia. Patient is unable to read and unable to write. Let's just talk about frontal lobe, the occipital lobe again from the beginning. Alright, let's take it step by step. Now, positive sign, you're going to see some visual hallucination and photopsia. Visual hallucinations, patient replaces what? His hallucinations with reality. Now, photopsia, short primitive what? Visual hallucinations that was arising due to short primitive irritation of what? Occipital lobe. Then we went further to talk about the what? The negative symmetric symptoms where we talk about achromatognosia, we talked about visual anosmia, we talked about chrodantopia, we talked about cortical blindness, we talked about a whole lot of things there. After that, we went further to talk about the negative word asymmetry, where we talk about alexia and then acalculia. Someone told me again to talk about the negative symmetric syndrome. We have visual anosmia, we have cortical blindness, or we have achromatognosia, which are unable to differentiate different quadrantopia and all those guys. These are some basic things. And negative asymmetry, we have Alexia Agbon Akakulia. Thank you very much for being with us all through the series. We are going to continue talking about other syndromes of other cranial nerve infection, bulbar affection, pseudobulbar syndrome, alternating syndrome. We're going to be talking about the oculomotor group of nerve, all the cranial nerves. Watch out for our further videos on greatness, God. Subscribe to this channel and you will get blessed with a whole lot of knowledge that God will help us reveal and unravel to ourselves to make us become great in our profession. Because one of the most important things is it's not passing the past. One of the most important things is what passing before your patient, being able to diagnose great things that will help solve the problems of this world. That's why you are greatest. Greatness is in you. God bless you.